بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters. Today I have another reaction video. In this reaction video, I'm going to be reacting to a sister who reverted to Islam. And the video says, from Christianity, Hinduism, Buddhism to Islam. So I think she went through to all these religions and then she chose Islam at the end. That's what I'm thinking. And then let's get to the video and see the story of the sister. Let's get to it.
Assalamu alaikum, guys. How I became Muslim video. Guys, I can't tell you the amount of times that I have told this story. Just not online. The easiest way is to start at the very beginning. So my journey to Islam began in 2021. Someone who has always believed in God, and I used to be Christian. I went to a Church of England school, and in my family, culturally, where I'm from in the world, if you believe in God, then it's kind of normal for you to be Christian. You don't really see many people branching out. Chapel every day. We had like an in-school vicar and a chaplain who would deliver our sermons every day. We would pray together every day. And a lot of school life did sort of circle around Church of England. So naturally, it kind of made sense for me to gravitate towards that, whilst I believed in God. Around 14 years old, I decided, you know, I definitely believe in God. And through all of this study at school and like, you know, chapel services, I get a step further and I wanted to confirm myself as a Christian into the religion. And I look back at this time and I think I didn't really know what on earth I was doing, what I was signing up for. It was a mark of my faith that I believed in God, and it was the logical next step for me. So I decided to become Christian. I didn't really have much understanding of what it meant to be Christian. You know, aspects of Christianity like the Holy Trinity were never really cemented in my understanding, and I often found that with many of my teachers, the more questions I would ask around certain questions, like I would always find I was getting a different answer and there was no consistency. So I kind of tried to push these things away for a while because it felt very uncomfortable to me that I had signed myself up to be a part of a religion that I didn't really understand, if I'm honest. A few more years passed and again, so many more questions about Christianity came up for me that I decided I couldn't really deal with and I couldn't understand in the context of my decision. I was very uncomfortable to learn these things and I just kind of pushed it down and I did find myself becoming very distant. Years go by, my teenage years were quite challenging in many ways. I found myself always looking for a connection with God, with spirituality, with something, and I was always craving, you know, to understand things on a deeper level, and I was always wanting to go deeper with every conversation, and I wasn't really finding the right thing for me. It led me to try out a lot of different things as a way of understanding, as a way of coping. And it was a really hard time, to be transparent. It was a very, very hard time for me. And it got to the stage where I eventually completely distanced myself from Christianity. 19, I've got very into sort of new age spiritual practices. Yet again, I found these things really interesting, but none of them brought me the sense of stability and peace that I was craving. And so I went on this journey for probably say around 22. And that was when I was at university. these years were probably the most challenging years that I've experienced in my life so far. Not because of university itself, but because of other aspects of my life, but mainly the relationships with people that I had around me. At this time, I was also studying a subject that I loved at university, and I kind of threw myself into that, especially in my final year. Really deep interest in religion, okay? So I took a whole semester where I studied Buddhism. I also looked into Hindu Sakta Tantra. I did a whole project around this and Hinduism. I found it so interesting. And then I studied a bunch of other religious modules. Kept finding, okay, this is so fascinating, but for this reason, it doesn't align with me and I can't accept it. And I wasn't finding what I was looking for. And I didn't really know what I was looking for, but I knew that I would find it. And I knew that I would know it when I found it. Heard to me one time, okay, I have ignored Islam, as haven't even had the slightest inclination to look into what it means, to look into any aspect of the religion. I just wasn't interested, okay? I thought that I knew the religion. I thought I had a lot of preconceived ideas about what Islam was. I had a lot of ideas about the way women were treated in Islam. And I frankly wanted absolutely no part in that. And that's what I thought at the time. That wasn't really a good enough answer for me to put away the study of an entire huge world religion. And at first, I honestly just, it was kind of an ego thing, because I love to learn and I love to tell people about the things that I've learned. And it became sort of a, no one was talking about it in my circles, so I kind of could drop really interesting insights into conversations that I was having with people. I could like impress people with my knowledge of this religion that no one knew about. And that's how it started. It started from an academic perspective. I wanted to know. But what I didn't expect to start happening was that my heart kind of began to soften to Islam. And eventually this all came into a point where I thought, I've learnt this much and I can't really live my life without incorporating this knowledge that I know, because I believe it's the truth. I decided to become Muslim, and bear in mind that this was an incredible shock, not only for my family, who all work in the fashion industry, so they're very conscious of like how things appear, appearances, and also for my friends, because I, you know, I have a history of being the opposite of a Muslim woman. And that was very, to become Muslim was the complete antithesis to how I lived my life before. So my friends were pretty shocked, but alhamdulillah, I'm so lucky that they are all very, you know, woke and accepting. And they really stood by me. They were my rocks throughout that time. And my family were, to put it lightly, they were incredibly shocked. They were pretty upset at first, to be honest, because again, they have all of the misconceptions about Islam that I did. They were very concerned for my safety, for my well-being. And then sort of like a month later, I came home being like, yes, I want to marry this guy, he's a Muslim. And that was like, ooh, I took a match to some petrol. I'm blessed to have my brother, Tom, throughout this whole process. I said on day one, you know, I think I want to become Muslim. He was absolutely incredible. I get emotional talking about him because I could never have asked for a better brother and more support. And he helped me a lot to get my parents to come around. I hadn't taken the Shahada yet. So I told my parents, you know, I want to become Muslim, and it would mean the world for me if you guys would all come to my Shahada, to like be there as I take this step into Islam. And I also invited my best friend Pip. They said yes, and that was amazing. That was absolutely amazing for me. And I was so, so happy.
To get a good family.
Like, this decision meant, I can't describe how much this decision meant to me. So to have my, oh, I'm getting emotional again. To have my family come with me for that was incredible. And we went to a wonderful mosque in Bristol and we all sat together and I took my Shahada, alhamdulillah, and it was the best day of my life. Becoming Muslim, reverting to Islam has changed my life on so many levels. I lack the words to describe how much peace, security, comfort and joy Islam has brought into my life. I found what I was looking for, alhamdulillah. I completely found what I was looking for, you know, probably in the past decade of my life. Allah guided me, alhamdulillah. And
alhamdulillah.
This whole journey, of course, is all through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this happened. And just developing that relationship with Him. You know, even before I took the Shahada, I was trying to pray. I was trying to connect with Allah. And, you know, He was listening. Alhamdulillah, He was listening.
Alhamdulillah.
And I just remember always asking, you know, if this is right for me, Allah, please make it easy. And he absolutely did, and it was the best decision that I've ever made in my life. So yeah, that is essentially my story. I'm sure I've missed many parts out, so I will clarify any questions in the comments that you guys leave. But also, if you like my abaya, this is my first set for my brand Dizzy. I am so excited to bring this to you guys. It's a brand that encapsulates my love of modest clothing and streetwear, and it would mean the world to have your support. I'm doing a very limited edition first drop of this, and if you want to get on my exclusive first look list, then DM me, because yeah, there's going to be very limited numbers of these, but I've literally been working on this for the past 2 years. So yeah, stay tuned.
Masha'Allah. Yeah, brothers and sisters, the video is ended. The sister explained very good in details. I don't know her name, I haven't heard, but just see in the description if I can find her name. The story was incredible and it's a very, very good story. Like, I don't have to add anything. Her family was fantastic. They're so good to her to be a Muslim. She didn't went through hardship because of her family's not allowing her, and she did a very good research. When you do research very good and you understand, and then you accept it, or you just say, hey, maybe I have to do more research, that's when you become a Muslim, and you become a good Muslim, successful Muslim. Don't do it for somebody. Do it for yourself. If that doesn't come into your heart, don't do it. So brothers and sisters, I have to end this video. And I will see you in the next video. Assalamu alaikum.